Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are finally gonna do the FabFitFun edit sale research videos. The way this works is everything in the beauty section, so they have little headings. You can click on beauty and you will find these categories. There's gonna be the skincare video, the bath and body video, the hair care video, and the makeup video. I'm gonna use this intro for all four videos because I don't want to film this four times, so you will see me in the same outfit and same makeup in all four videos. This video is going to be the bath and body video. All the brands will be in alphabetical order from A through Z. If the is in front of the name, then it's gonna be in the T section. If the product is cruelty-free, you'll see a little cruelty-free bunny up in the corner. It just used to take me way too long to say this product is cruelty-free or this product is not cruelty-free. So I just decided to put a little photo up. Hopefully that's helpful to some people. I know if you're listening to video and not watching the video, it's probably not helpful. Sorry about that. It's just the video would be like over an hour long for some of these if I did do that. Really quickly, what is a FabFitFun edit sale? FabFitFun is a seasonal subscription box. You spend $49.99 and you get a box valued at over $200 four times a year. Every time you get a box, they also have a sale called an add-on sale. In between two boxes, so let's say the fall and winter box, where in between those two boxes right now, they have an edit sale. The sales have some really amazing brands. You can find some great finds. There's also some duds too. That's exactly why I make this video. The fall add-on and edit sale, we're currently in the fall edit sale, are both really good times to get holiday gifts because they will ship to you. Most likely they will ship to you in time for the holidays. You must be a FabFitFun subscription box member in order to shop the sales. And honestly, the sales are my favorite perk of any of the FabFitFun perks. I've got so much great stuff from sales in the past. If you want to become a member, I'll leave my referral link down below in the description box as well as in the comments. It does give you $10 off your first box and it does give me a credit that the company says thank you for referring a friend. That's all the details you need. Now let's get started with the research. For the Ahava Essential Trio, not found as a trio, so not enough reviews available, and this one was made in Israel. For the Ahava Eucalyptus Dead Sea Bath Salt, it has a 4.5 star rating with 207 reviewers. Positives did say they had soft or smooth skin, and then some mentioned that it was good for eczema or psoriasis, but I'm not making any medical claim here. These are just in more than one review online. Negatives say it had a chemical scent or that it didn't have a eucalyptus scent, and some people also said it didn't have a scent at all, and this product is made in Israel. For the Ahava Sea Kiss Hand Cream Trio, it had a 4.8 star rating with 423 reviewers. Positives were saying that it's great for dry skin, it has a very thick consistency, but it still absorbs, and people did like the scent in general. There are a few that didn't, but almost everyone else did, and there were not really negative comments on this one, and this is also made in Israel. I also like the Sea Kiss scent. I own the Sea Kiss scent. I don't remember exactly where I got it. I think in a beauty box. And it reminds me of like the mixture of a beach scent with a light floral scent as well. For the Ahava Water Body Kit, this is a 4.1 star rating with 11 reviewers. Positives did say it was moisturizing and it had a high quality feel. The negatives were that the scent is too strong, that it's too pricey, and there was one person that said the scent is like baby wipes. I would say that this is a scent that I don't like. The water scent is one that I personally don't like. That doesn't mean it's bad, it's all personal preference, right? This product was made in Israel. For the Kali Cosmetics Foot Cream with Menthol in Taroko, this is a 4.3 star rating with 47 reviewers. We did get this in a FabFitFun box. People said it has an orange scent, it's a good consistency, it's a thick cream, and that it's not greasy. The negatives were mostly about the menthol. Either they didn't like the feeling of the menthol or they didn't like the mixture of the menthol with the orange scent, and this product was made in Hong Kong. For the Carter & Jane, the Everything Neroli Oil, there were not enough reviews available and this product was made in the USA. For the Catherine Malandrino Style de Paris gift set, this is a 4.5 star rating with 53 reviewers. Positives were about the scent and it was described as classy or sophisticated or a soft scent. And one person even said a slight honey scent. The negatives were that it's not strong enough or that it doesn't last all day, and this product is made in the USA. For the Daily Concepts Daily Body Scrubber has a 4.6 star rating with 40 reviewers. Positive say it feels great and it comes with a holder, so like you can keep it up in your bathroom, and that it helps suds up the soap very well and it's exfoliating. Negative say that it didn't last very long or that it was cheaply made, and this product is made in Mexico. For the Daily Concepts Daily Mesh Sponge, not enough reviews available, and this product is made in Mexico. For the Dermasuria Exfoliating Mitt, this has a 5-star rating with 20 reviewers, and a lot of the reviewers were saying this is very rough, but in a good way, that it like works at exfoliating really well, and they saw a visible difference, and several said like it's not painful, it's just very scrubby. And this, of course, with 5 stars, did not have negative reviews, and it's made in China. For the Dermalect Vascial Spider Vein Treatment, this is 3.5 star with 10 reviewers, and it has really mixed reviews. Like half the people say it worked, and half the people say they saw absolutely no difference. And this one is made in the USA. For the Flight Mode Extreme Hydration Foot Mask, not enough reviews available, and made in South Korea. For all 4 of the Frutia products, so there's an Orchard Quince Body Essence Moisturizer, an Orchard Quince Body Wash, a Peach Body Essence Moisturizer, and a Peach Body Wash. All of these are less than 10 reviews available, and all of them are made in South Korea. For the Grace and Stella Dr. Pedicure Exfoliating Foot Treatment, it has a 4.2 star rating with 168 reviewers. A lot of the positives were saying that you have to soak your feet before you use it, that it peels for a lot longer than other foot peeling products, and that they got soft results, like soft feet. The negatives were that it did not work, or that it peeled in tiny patches instead of like in strips, so it was like a little bit more messy than other things they've used, and a lot of people are saying it's not as good as a more expensive version of a foot peel. And this product was made in China. For the Human and Kind Body Soufflé and Body Wash Duo, we did get the soufflé in a box, I think, last year. And the soufflé does have reviews online as a 4.7 with 204 reviewers. Positives were about the scent. It's like a fresh citrus scent. Some people said that it's a light scent, and others said it's not greasy and the skin just really soaks it up. There were no negative trends for this product, and it's made in Belgium. The other body wash did not have reviews available. For the Musi Bath Soak Duo, this has a 4.7 star rating with 14 reviewers. Positives were about the great scent and that it's relaxing. Negatives, it only had one review that was negative. With 14, that kind of happens, and that person just said it's not good for sensitive skin, and this one is made in the USA. For the Spongel products, a lot of these don't have enough reviews available, but I'm gonna give you the notes of what it's supposed to smell like. And so for the Ginger Bergamot Box Flower, we actually have this one twice in the sale for some reason. Not enough reviews available for this one, and it says aldehydic, orange, grapefruit, aromatic, ginger, floral, fir balsam, and patchouli. I actually own this one, and I really think the ginger stands out. Like, I do think you can get really nice ginger scent from this one, and it is made in the USA. For the Spongel Botanica Butterfly Tobacco Flower, not enough reviews available on this one. These scents are bergamot, green fig, rosemary, juniper, sheer lavender, cedarwood, and sandalwood. I don't own this one. Also made in the USA. All of these are gonna be made in the USA, actually, for Spongel. For the Spongel Bourbon Vanilla, it has a 4.8 star rating with 69 reviewers, and the positives say it's a lighter vanilla scent, like it's not overpowering, that it's very balanced, and that it's not too sweet. And then it doesn't really have negative reviews, but the scent is orange, milky, coconut, jasmine, golden honey, gourmand, and creamy vanilla. The next one is the Spongel Box Flower Sugar Crush. Not enough reviews available on this one, but the scent is pomegranate seed, custard apple, red berries, star jasmine, muguet, cherry blossom, sugar musk, golden amber, and vanilla cream. Then for the Spongel Box Flower Violet Leaf, this one didn't have enough reviews available either, but the scent is black peppercorn, lemon peel, fresh ginger, basil, violet leaf, coriander, vetiver, and tree moss. And then for the Spongel Coconut Verbena Hand Cream, this had a 4.9 star rating with 72 reviewers. We got this in a box as well, which is probably why it has so many reviews. They say a little goes a long way, it absorbs easily, even though it has a thicker feel, and that it works really well for sensitive skin. The negatives were that the scent is not coconut enough, that's really the only thing, but they were still giving it a positive review. For This Works Deep Sleep Bath Soak, we have a 4.7 star rating with 114 reviewers. They did say it helps with sleep or relaxing, and a few mention it also helps with anxiety. Negatives say there's not enough per container or it's not a good value, and this is made in the UK. For This Works Pillow Talk set, it has a 4.5 star rating with 144 reviewers. Positives say it's a calming scent, it does what it claims, and they did get deep sleep. Negatives say it's too expensive or that the scent is too light, and this product is made in the UK. For the This Works Sleep Plus Dream Body, it has a 4.7 star rating, 37 reviewers. Again, people saying this helps with sleep, that it's moisturizing, it's not greasy, and there were no negative trends for this product, and this is made in the UK. For the Unsun Face Serum, has a 4.3 star rating with 12 reviewers. Positive say it had a tropical scent, a light feel, that it was tinted and they didn't have a cast, or that it was a slight cast. I would say like most reviews were saying that, like no white cast or slight cast, but there was one reviewer that did leave a negative comment that said on her skin that it did have a white cast. She described her skin tone like, she said, Beyonce's skin color. I guess it probably has a lot to do with your own skin tone, and this one is made in the USA. For the Yuen Oil Botox Oil Body Shot, not enough reviews available for this, and this one was made in Lithuania. And for the Zago Milano Nourishing Body Scrub, not enough reviews available for this one, and made in Italy. That's our last video. We are done for the season. Happy car editing to all my annuals today, and then it will open up on September 30th if you are not annual. I will probably remind you guys about this video. That's it for this section. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!